more coming.
Hi, Mr. Very nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Thank you very much for taking so much time.
Well, I'm pleased to do it.
This is Mr. Yoshida.
Hello. Nice to see you. Thank you.
This is Mr. Proba.
Good to see you.
Mr. Ito.
Nice to see you.
Good greeting for you.
Well, thank you, and return my.
Please to meet you.
Nice to see you.
Mr. Osawa.
Well, I'm honored and pleased to have you.
Mr. Kanishiki.
Well, we're looking forward to it.
And this is Mr. Kashiwagi.
Yes. Hello, Mr.
Ichimura.
Nice to see you.
And Mr. Ichimura.
This is a great honor.
Right. We're doing an interview.
Right. This is your
first
time. Second,
I have to visit Tokyo.
No, this is, I've been there before. This will be definitely the third.
The first time being when he was a governor.
Right. President Nixon sent me on a couple of journeys for him.
Really looking forward to.
Yes, very much.
Do you expect a lot to be accomplished?
Yes, I do. I think we're all getting more and more on the same track.
Well, I hope you will have a great time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Yoshida?
Mr. President, let me ask one question. Japanese military authorities are really concerned about the sharp appreciation of Japanese yen vis-a-vis dollar. Do you think U.S. dollar is strong enough at this moment?
Well, I know that it is beneficial in the whole area of trade, certainly for us to have a closer relationship with our currencies. I think the currencies have been out of line with the dollar far too high in comparison. And whether the figure as of now is the correct balance between us, I think it is much closer to reality than the previous figure has been.
Thank you very much.
Thank you
very
much.
Thank you
very
much.
I need you. I need you. And besides this one question, what sort of impression did you get when about the third term of Prime Minister and so many times? What sort of impression did you get?
Oh, well, listen, I think he and I have developed a very warm, continuing friendship. Close personal relationship, and I look forward to seeing him again. Of course, enjoyed having him here, even though briefly at the Camp David.
And how about that re-election of Prime Minister Nakasone?
Obviously, for my friendship, I wish him all the very best. At the same time, I have to be cautious about sounding as if I'm trying to influence the election
process. Okay, thank you very much.
Do you have any plan to go abroad after this trip, except Moscow?
Well, that's the only one. If they come here in 86, I had agreed that I would go there in 87. I'm sure there will be other trips, but I don't know that we will escape.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Mr. Abe?
I'm originally a political reporter, so that I have a question for you. This one. How do you feel about the Japanese success of post-Nakasone? I mean, we met here with Prime Minister Abe and the Finance Minister Takeshita. How do you think about those people?
Well, you say, what do I think of them?
Yeah.
Well, I have a very warm feeling, very warm regard, because I think that your government and the people have been working very hard with us. I'm trying to establish a better trade relationship.
Yeah. That's all.
Thank you. Mr. Ishikawa.
Mr. President, just one question. While you're in Tokyo, do you have anything other than official schedule you're looking for, such as private visit?
No, there won't be time for us. We have a busy legislative session here. But on previous trips there, I did have an opportunity to go to the original capital of Japan, to go to Osaka, so I have seen more of Japan, and I will be allowed to see this trip.
Not this time.
No.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Mr. Rosal?
Mr. President, let's see, there is sort of a very heavy, extremely heavy security in Japan.
Very
security situation.
Yes, well, I'm a little used to that because it's even true right here.
Mm-hmm.
It's right. Sad, but it's the state of the world today. I'm quite sure very few, if any, presidents before me have had to be governed by as much security as we have today.
Why don't you try to see some just a sort of ordinary person beside the Prime Minister Long in Japan, sort of just ordinary sort of Japanese people?
Oh, well, listen, I would relish that. And as I say, those other visits, we've had some opportunities to do that.
Uh-huh.
And I don't know how much time. When you look at the schedule of meetings, you find
sure.
that going to keep us pretty busy.
Yes, sure. Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Nice to meet you.
Actually, I don't want to ask any questions anymore. I just hope you enjoyed your trip to Japan. Enjoy yourself.
Well, I'm sure you have. I'm looking forward to it.
Yes.
I always have enjoyed it.
Yes, I hope so.
Thank you, sir. Mr. Kashiwaki?
Mr. President, my newspaper located in the northern island of Japan, Hokkaido. And do you have any idea to visit Hokkaido?
Not on this.
It's a very strategic.
As I said, I think the schedule is too tight for us to be able to do that.
I see. But it's a very strategic point against Russia. Do you think the defense of Hokkaido is enough?
Well, I am one who believes that one of the great tragedies is that the Soviet Union saw fit to occupy the island that it has. And I still look forward to a day when perhaps they'll rejoin the rest of the world in not attempting to occupy properties not their own.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
I hope so.
Mr.
President, do you have any plan in Japan to meet us personally with some people except politicians?
Well, they're not going to give us very much time.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm sure just in the normal processes and in and around the hotel and so forth, you get to see some people, and I look forward to that.
Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mr. President.
Thank you all for coming in. I'm sorry it had to be so hurried. But I have some of our congressmen waiting. All right.
They've got you over there.
See you tomorrow. Today, I'm going to wish you a welcome. I realize that you've been involved in a tax reform markup this morning. And however, during the last 6 days, you as well as I have been involved in another issue that comes within the Finance Committee's jurisdiction. And first, I want to thank each of you for supporting our efforts to obtain fast-track implementing authority for a Canada Free Trade Agreement. Since I didn't have the opportunity to visit with all of you, I wanted to have you down to personally thank you for the support that you gave. And let me say a few things about the upcoming negotiations. As I said yesterday to others that I was talking to, we'll consult with you every step of the way so that you'll be aware of what we're doing, the progress we're making, and can have your input there and the ideas that you may have with regard to those negotiations. The second is our goal to come up with a product that allows fair opportunities for American businesses and industries to compete, and it's my hope that your vote yesterday will be but the first step in a process that will be of historic importance to the United States and its relationship with one of the closest and most dependable allies. Your votes of conviction yesterday, I know, are going to enhance the political and economic relationship that we have with America, many years to come. Within minutes of being told of the vote yesterday, I was on the phone to Prime Minister Mulroney and made him a very happy man. I made his day.
He must have been a little nervous.
Yes. And I told him of what I had done with regard to consulting with you as the negotiations went forward. You know, his problem is a little different, and that has to do with the control or the authority and autonomy that the leaders of their various provinces have. And he told me that he had agreed with those leaders that he would consult with them throughout all the negotiations so that they too would be involved. So I think it sounds like we really done something that shows great statesmanship and on both sides of the border, and something that could lead to an enhancement of the relationship that we've had. We're all aware it's a very unusual relationship worldwide. I know that some of you made some very difficult choices yesterday, and as I've said before, I'm deeply grateful to you for it. And I assure you that the interests of the American people will be foremost in our efforts, and we will welcome your input throughout these negotiations. And now, before I turn to Clayton for additional comments on our negotiations, I'd like to change the subject and speak on just for a moment on another issue, and that is tax reform. I know you've been meeting today, and I just want to remind you that tax reform.
You thought that I like it. That comes the punchline.
I think it's one of the highest priorities for this Congress, and I hope that your committee can produce a revenue neutral bill that meets the guidelines that were expressed in our original proposal during consideration of tax reform in the House. So again, thanks for your support, and now I'm going to ask Clayton to say a brief word about our approach to these negotiations.
Well, thanks, Mr. President. The first thing I'd like to do is just supplement your comments.
Rob.